إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of Al-Majalis Al-Ramadaniya, sittings and gathering of Ramadan by Sheikh Abu Khalid Walid Al-Minesi. May Allah reward him the best for his booklet. And basically, Alhamdulillah, by the will of Allah and his leave, that we had finish the book, and today we're going to be discussing the last chapter in his book, and this the chapter number 11 related to Eid al-Fitr. Eid from Ada Ya'udu, from something which comes again and again and again. This what is Eid. The word feast is not actually what is meant in the word in Arabic, but Eid is a set occasion that comes every month or every year and return again and again. So this is called Eid because it comes again, return again and again. Nevertheless, the term that used in English, feast or celebration, al-fitr, is related to breakfast or breaking fast. So the feast of breaking the fast, okay? It came in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. للصائم فرحتان يفرحهما إذا أفطر فرح بفطره وإذا لقي ربه فرح بصومه. A fasting person have a two occasion of joys and happiness. One is when he break his fast, and one when he meet his Lord Almighty Allah, he will be happy for his fasting. So this hadith is saying, a person who observing the fasting, he have two occasion which make him happy. One is when you break your fast, and one when you meet Allah in the day of judgment. When you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, you will see the reward that you gained due to the fact that you was fasting, you be happy and joy that you had fast. The first occasion when you break your fast, and there is a portion of breaking the fast, or a temporary, or whatever you want to call it, which is that it comes with the sunset. With the sunset, you break your fast. And it seems that all of us experience this, all right? That when you hear the adhan, that you can see the emotion of the people or the happiness on their face, that they accomplish something and they had finished the day. Nevertheless, that when it comes the feast, the completion of the month, 29 days or 30 days, and depending on the crescent, will be the happiness of the completion of the obligation and the duty that Allah had requested us to do it. So the joy is not because toys and celebration or seeing the people or whatever it is. The main thing that Allah had enabled you, give you the ability that you fulfill one of the main obligations, the main pillars of Islam, which is the fasting of Ramadan. And we understand that if it's not is the tawfiq and the guidance of Allah, we could not make the fasting. Allah is the one who gave us the patience, and He gave us the determination that we be able to go ahead with this task. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in Surah Yunus, verse number 58, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Say, O Muhammad, indeed by Allah's favor and His mercy, for that they should be joyous, and Allah is better more than what they gather or what they have. That mean your happiness that Allah had enabled you to fast. Okay? It's not your might, it's not your power. And to some people that they are not supposed to fast, or the doctor told them fast, not to fast, and they fast, okay? So is Allah is the one who makes things easy, okay? You found that the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the supplication, he gave it to Mu'adh, and he told him, oh Mu'adh, I love you. So do not forget to say, after each prayer, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Oh Allah, enable me. You see, this is the point here. If Allah is not going to give you the strength and the guidance and firm your feet, you're not going to be able to do it, even if you're strong and healthy. Okay? So we call in Allah and we ask Allah that He assist us, enable us. Allahumma a'inni, help me, assist me on your remembrance and being grateful to you and to worship you in the best manner. Alright? This is a special dua, a gift the Prophet gave it to one of the companions by name Mu'adh. And we had learned it, and we're supposed to say it after every prayer. Okay? Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the second occasion of happiness, and this is when we meet Him in the day of judgment, and which is going to be a caller, in that day and is saying all fasting people come enter Jannah from this special gate which you call Ar-Rayyan. Nobody else enter Jannah from this gate other than the fasting people, okay? When is the fasting people enter, it will be shut, nobody else will enter. So this will be the second choice, okay? So the first choice at Maghrib or at Eid, when you break the finish, completion. And the second one, that the one that we're waiting on it, this will be in the day of judgment, you will see the reward of your fasting and for you to enter Jannah with no hardship, and it will be a special gate for the people who observe the fasting. It is recommended that in the day of Eid that we congregate each other by saying تقبل الله منا ومنكم. May Allah accept from us and from you. Okay, instead of the word Eid Mubarak, blessed Eid, happy Eid, the proper thing that you make in dua to your Muslim brother or sister, and also they also making the dua for you. تقبل الله منا ومنكم. May Allah accept from us and from you. It is allowable for Muslims to bring joys and happiness to each other in that day. In general, Islam is saying that we're supposed to be a source of happiness and joys for each other. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, أَحَبُّ الْعَمَلِ إِلَى اللَّهِ سُرُورٌ تُدْخِلُهُ عَلَى مُسْلِمٍ أو تقضي عنه دينا أو تكشف عنه كربة أو تطرد عنه جوعا. One of the most dearer deed to Allah is a pleasure and happiness that you bring it to other Muslim. Subhanallah. Arhamukallah. You see, in the top of the list is what? Something that you do it or you say it that it will bring a pleasure to the Muslim. He or she is something strongly recommended in Islam, and one of the best things that Allah likes that you bring a happiness to other Muslim, okay? Otherwise, you can go to the next step or paying his debt or removing one of his calamity or feeding him or her to keep the hunger and the starvation away from them. So alhamdulillah, you have a table full of goodness that is pleasing to Allah, and we should compete with each other how we can make each other, the other Muslim, that happy and have a joys, especially in the day of Eid. Also, it is recommended in the end of the month that we make the takbir. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah number 2, verse 185, وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So Allah did it like this, that you can complete the number of the days 30 days or 29 days, and that you magnify Allah by saying Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, and you make this takbir due to the fact that Allah had guided you. Okay? So we're showing our appreciation to Allah by saying takbir for the reason that Allah guided us to be Muslims. Again, it's not how smart you are, how strong you are. And that you make takbir for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that because He had guided you to Islam, guided you to practice the siyam and to do the things Allah pleasing to Allah. Tukabbirullah ala ma hadakum wa la'allakum tashkurun, and that you be grateful and thankful to Allah. And we do this tasbih, tahmid, takbir after the prayer, and we also do this in the other Eid during the Hajj. Okay, Allah said, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُم مَنَاسِكَكُمْ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. That when you finish your rituals during the Hajj, you went around the Kaaba, you went between the Safa and Marwa, you went to Mina, to Muzdalifa, to Arafah. So Allah saying, make takbir, glorify the name of Allah. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had enabled you to do this manasik and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the same way that you remember your family, because in Hajj you are a distant from your family, and now the Hajj is about to finish, so you're so excited. Now all what can come to your mind is, I'm about to finish and go back home and see my family. So Allah says, so remember Allah same way that you remember in your family, or more even that you remember your family. That the love of Allah is supposed to be more to you, and the remembrance of Allah is supposed to be more than even remembering your family. Why? So now always you found the remembrance of Allah after a major ibadah. Like after Salah, we say Subhanallah 33, Alhamdulillah 33, Allahu Akbar 33. Okay? So, and you found our Eid comes after a major pillars of Islam. So, one Eid comes after what? After finish Ramadan. And one Eid comes after what? After making Hajj. So, as if it teaching you that your real happiness as a Muslim, it comes when you accomplish something of the obedience of Allah. And this is a great sign for you to be a true believer, that when your good deed pleases you and when your bad deed displeases you. Now this is a sign that you are a believer. So when Allah enable you to give in charity, or that you assist somebody, or that you fast, you feel that this joys. But when you do something bad, you regret, you feel bad. Okay? So this is a sign of faith. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislate the celebration after the fasting with the takbir. Or that the person will start after seeing the crescent. So if today, as example, 29th of Ramadan, and we see that the new crescent, so that means the next day is Eid. Otherwise, we will do what? We complete Ramadan to 30 days. But from the night before Eid, you will start the takbir. From after Maghrib, you will start the takbir. All right? And we'll end with what? With Salat al-Eid. Version of takbir that it came from narration of Ibn Mas'ud, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. So this narration is what? With two takbir for each one. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. Allah is the greatest, Allah is the greatest. There is no deity worthy of worship other than Allah. Allah is the greatest and Allah is the greatest. And to Allah belong all the praise. It is allowable or recommended raising the voice with the takbir. When you leave your house also going to the musalla, the prayer place for the Eid, while you're walking or driving or going to the musalla, and while you're waiting for the imam to come to lead the salah and to deliver the khutbah, you make the takbir also, okay? And a Muslim, every time he will remember that Allah had guided him and that he blessed him to worship him, he will make the takbir. Also, it is recommended that for the Eid that you wear the best of your clothes. Okay? That because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do so, and he have burda, it is specially for the Eid, special dress that he has it for the Eid and for Jum'ah. Okay? It is recommended that the person to take a shower before they go to the Eid prayer. Salat al-Eid, the prayer of Eid, is one of the symbols of Islam, and encouraged that all Muslims to go for it, men and women, children, young or old. As Umm Atiyah, may Allah be pleased with her, had told us that أمرنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أن نخرج هن في الفطر والأضحى العواتق والحيط وذوات الخدور. Okay, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they order us that we let everybody, we know why this is said, because the salah of a woman in her house more rewarded. Okay, the more that she is in privacy and away from the public eye is much reward for her. The men, they get 25 degrees by praying in the mosque, or 27. The woman will get her reward more when she staying in privacy and stay away from the public eye. But for the Eid, it is the recommendation that everybody will go, so they can be witness to see the number of the Muslims and the strength of the Muslims and the gathering and the unity of the Muslims. This is something is very recommended. Even women during their menses, although they are not going to make salah, but it is recommended for them also, what? For them to go out of their houses to go to attend, but they do not pray with them. We're going to stop here, inshallah. We'll continue tomorrow this chapter, if Allah will. Okay, and inshallah, the breaking of fast is outside. We encourage you that you go and break your fast outside, inshallah. Anybody have question, comments, concern related to our chapter for today? Inshallah, we'll continue tomorrow. Thank you. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. May Allah knows best.